For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. You are now tuning into the program, Strong Nation, with your host, Pastor Marcos.
Very good afternoon to you. Be blessed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Friday. This is a very special day. Why, Pastor, it is a very special day? Because it was on a Friday that Jesus said, it is finished. And this is what I want to bring to your attention right now. Why he said it is finished? Because in that moment he determined it would be the end of problems, the end of failure, the end of losses, the end of distress to those who believe. And when I say to those who believe, I say to those who would make a pact with his word, those who would stand upon his word, those who would base their actions upon his words. Why is it many people, they do not benefit from the word of God? Because though they may hear it, they do not stand on it. They do not make a pact with God. They do not decide to follow the guidance that God gives. Because when a person decides to follow God's guidance, prosperity is the outcome. And I'm going to show to you people who are failing and now they are successful because they decided to make a pact with God. They decided to follow exactly what you see here. When a pact with God is made, the word of God, my friend, it is written. His words cannot return to him empty. And in order to show you that, let us watch these testimonies.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
Tell us, what do for you?
Pastor, for a while now, I wanted to do two courses so I could get more qualified and take up another position. But at the time, I only had the enough funds to pay for one course. So after receiving the key, I used my faith and I was determined that I must pay for these courses before December. And last week, Friday, I received the commission and I was able to pay to start my courses.
God opened the door.
Yes. Yes.
The key word.
Yes.
Great is your faith.
Amen.
What did God do for you?
Pastor, last week you said to come and Pastor Philip anoint with the oil, anoint my car. Pastor, when I went into the bank Wednesday, I received money I wasn't expecting.
Received their money. When she went to the bank, she received an amount that she wasn't. Why? Because she believed. Are we together here? If you believe, the unexpected will happen to you as well. Great is your faith.
My name is Dave Jatton. Before I knew about the church, I think I had a lot of financial problems. Money wasn't staying in my hands and things, and I was trying to build a house. Waiting on the bank, but at the time, I didn't have a job, a permanent job. I got all that through the church too. So I was denied many times. You can't qualify for the house from the government, nor from the bank. Until I come and one day I receive a phone call of a new job, a permanent job. Then I started that job, I applied for the house. It could have been about 3 or 4 years I've been waiting. Then turned down 3 times by them, forgetting about them, and going to the bank now. When we acquire a piece of land that was suitable in Rio Claro, that we could afford, that the bank will buy and build the house, I ran into a lot of delays. Over 2 years waiting for documents. It made me feel real down and depressed because you know, I was wondering how long you're going to have to keep renting. I know I was watching my wife and, you know, your father, family, you know, because you're renting, you're living in a little place. So it made me feel real depressed and real down. And but I keep on fighting and I keep coming to the church until the victory came. My wife's waiting for that. One day the phone rang about minutes or seven with somebody telling us that I qualify for a house to come and see it. But I didn't believe it. I thought it was a prank because the time they call and all them things. But I went the next day. Saw the house and I came to Port of Spain. It took me 2 days to get the house. 1 day to do all the paperwork in Port of Spain here to transfer, and the next day was to receive the keys. The middle of this year, I saw a great change in finance. Money that was not built that just disappeared, and you don't know, things will just keep breaking down, all kind of things, just taking it. I saw it stabilize. I'm paying the mortgage for the house, buying what I want still, and still I'm saving money, which I could not do before. Everything changing, health, finance, love life, everything, marriage, everything have been transforming slowly, but I've seen the progress. I'll advise anyone, come to the church, do your chain of prayer and be faithful in your tithes and things. That's how I conquer everything. It works, it really works.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
This is what is happening every Monday in our Strong Nation Gathering of Faith at 5 p.m. in our national headquarters, number 40, South Key, Port of Spain. And this is what's going to take place in your life if you join us to make a pact with God. And speaking of a pact with God, I want to show you more results. People who were very skeptical about how their lives would become, people who are skeptical about their future, people who are hopeless about their finances, but after they have made a pact with God, everything changed. And the same will take place in your life. Let us watch.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
Tell us, what did God do for you?
Well, it all started with my wife. She received the key when you gave it all the first time. So for the business that we have, the wrecking service, after she received the key, we started receiving more jobs. And I only received my key last week. So I received the key last week, Monday. And while I used the key on the truck, I think it was Thursday, and someone called the afternoon for a job. And they just called to get a price, right? So I gave them the price. And later that afternoon, they called to confirm that they would go with the price that I gave them for the job. So I had to do the job the Friday, which was the first of this month. And since Friday till today, I've had jobs continuously.
Non-stop?
Non-stop.
So the door was open?
Yes, it was.
This is the growth in 1 week. How much more can God do if you remain firm to the purpose? Who understands this? Great is your faith. So tell us, what did God do for you?
I think when they said they would turn on your phone, you will get a phone.
Just a moment. Last week, what happened? I said when you turn on your phone, what will happen?
You will get a phone.
You get a call.
I get 3 calls for a job. One on at Digo. I was at the opening kitchen 3 years ago. And the body covered all. Yesterday, when I was going home, call my phone and told me come down here this afternoon and I will get back my things then. But then I was running that kitchen for 9 years. I take sick and I went to there, you know? And when I come, they call me back to go and open back that kitchen. The kitchen get taken away from the man that I was running it for. Somebody else take it over. And they take it from me and give it to somebody else. And I was working with and I get 3 calls, so 3 different doors.
So God opened 3 different doors for you.
Yes.
The devil tried to close one, but God opened 3. Does the key work?
Yes.
Is this purpose working?
Yes.
What you have to tell those who are here perhaps for the first time?
Well, I will tell them to continue doing what they're doing, and he will open that door for them.
Miss Elizabeth, tell us. What was the problem? What did God do?
Starting a new business from the meetings with the government. I started the business underneath a tent. And today now I have a food cart. I was paying it on and I finished paying my cash debt, $19,000.
When did you start?
I started about a year now.
A year?
Yes, I gave testimony when I started.
But now, how things are going?
It's slow, not going to show for sure.
It's a movie.
Yes.
You are seeing progress.
Yes, I'm seeing progress. And then now I get a promotion.
What a promotion?
Yes.
At work?
Yes.
Were you expecting that promotion?
No, no.
When did the promotion come through?
Oh, 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago?
Yes.
The door was open.
Yes.
God is blessed.
Yes, all the time.
Are we stopping there or moving on? Set a new target, don't lose focus, God will do much more for you. And strong hand clap to Jesus.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
This God that has worked in the life of all these people, He also can work in your life. No matter what has been happening to you, no matter if this week you have had losses, if you have closed your doors, I mean your business doors, if you have lost your job, if things are not working out for you, if you have so many debts to pay and you have no means to do so, I am telling you, I guarantee you, if you make a pact with the Word of God, everything will change. This Word here has power to change your life. This Word here has power to bring into reality what for you has been but a dream. And He is going to do so. All you have to do is to believe. All you have to do is to base your faith, your actions upon His Word. In order for you to know how, let us watch more testimonies. Because God doesn't stop working in the strong nation. Those who have a pact with God, every Monday, they are seeing themselves moving forward. And if you join us this Monday at 5 p.m., you are going to see yourself moving forward as well. Let us watch.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
What was the problem? What did God do for you?
Pastor, I started building 2 years ago, and I was stuck with the roof. And then the week before you came, Pastor Philip said, sometimes we stop our own blessings. We need to move on, wait for next year. And the very next day, I took all the information I had considered, the materials and the tickets. I went and I got estimates. The next day, I went and I see about a loan. A week after that, I get through with the loan. And the roof is up, and things are just going ahead.
Doors were open. You see progress now.
Yes.
Now the roof is in place.
So my aim is to move
by the end of the month. So by the end of the month, you'll be a new house.
Yes.
Dream come true. Doors will open.
Doors open.
Blessed you. And strong hand clap to Jesus.
My name is Miss Burnett. My life before I came to the Universal Church was a struggle. I have 5 children and I'm a single parent. Things were very hard bringing up 5 children on my own. I work various places and the money just couldn't stay. It was a struggle to pay the bills, to buy food. Everything was a struggle. I used to feel very depressed. I used to pray a lot and ask God to take me out of that situation. Yeah, the worst times was when there was no money for food. I used to sit down and cry. When there was no money for food, I used to go out and look to see what little end I could get to do to buy something. Coming to the Universal Church really strengthened me and believed that I could come out of this situation. I spoke with the pastor and he told me to come back the Wednesday, but I couldn't go because I had an appointment, and I went the Friday. Things turned around because now I'm getting a little work, and the money that I get, I could do more than I used to do before with it. So I thank God for that. Today, I no longer struggle. I am working on building my own home and I pay my bills. I am asking for more blessings. I will tell people to do a chain of prayer and to go to the Universal Church and seek God's blessing.
My name is Allison. Before coming to the Universal Church, I had plenty financial problems. With my vehicles, I would get work, collect my salary after paying bills. It's like, you know, where my money gone? I used to feel depressed, you know, because there are things to be done, like the money to do it wasn't there because I had no extra help coming in, you know, was just what my job and thing. And the car will get from one problem to the next. I fix this, another problem. And it's like, you know, I was just frustrated at times. A friend of mine who used to attend the Universal Church, I told her one day what I was going through, and she invited me to the Universal Church. When I went there the morning, was a Monday for financial breakthrough. And after hearing of the different, you know, ways and means how to go about, how to use your faith, because my faith sometimes will go, I took up the challenge with it. Hearing about the tithes, I started to tithe as a tither. And after tithing, I started seeing where my money, you know, having money in hand. After I finished tithe, I was able to have money in hand to do whatever little I had to do. The Monday when we did the key, I had to go to get my American visa, you know. And, you know, you go in there with fright, sort of way, but I wasn't. I took the key with me even when I went for my visa, you know, and I asked God to open that door, and He did. You know, I was granted it. My life today is blessed because I lack nothing. You know, day by day, God has been blessing me with different, you know. Even I started a little small business where He has been blessing me with also. So I always have money in hand. Today, my life is transformed.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
So my dear, time has come for you to overcome. Time has come for you to succeed. Time has come for you to have a breakthrough. And if you are going through problems and you'd like an advice, you'd like to speak to us privately, you'd like to speak to us online, or you'd like to speak to us over the phone, you can get in touch with us through these numbers, 389-9880 or 709-8062. 389-9880, 709-8062. Or you can get hold of us online through our online pastor. If you want to get hold of us right now online, follow these guidelines.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
Perhaps with all the situation the world is facing nowadays, you feel lonely, frustrated, and have no one to talk to. Perhaps you're under quarantine and isolated from loved ones, and going to church and speaking to a pastor face to face is no longer an option. Thinking about you, the Universal Church created the online pastor live chat. 24 hours a day, pastors are on standby to listen to you, give a word of faith, and pray for you and your family. Completely free and confidential. To access this service, visit ulfn.org/online-pastor. When you click on the specific problem or the Speak to a Pastor button, a dialog box will pop up. Fill in your information. Agree to the terms and begin chatting immediately. You have three options: text, voice, and video. Need to speak to a pastor today? Just visit ulfn.org/online-pastor. Available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, free to all.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
My dear friend, we are approaching the end of our program. However, before that, we are going to pray for you. Prepare yourself, because when we come back, it will be our moment of prayer.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
When no one else gives you the light of day, or even to hear your voice becomes a burden, prayer is the way to get the hope and strength you need to overcome your troubles. Please close your eyes. It's time for prayer.
It's now our moment of prayer. Let us talk to God. My God and Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I determine that those who pray with us, they are going to have a weekend of victory, a weekend of blessings, a weekend of positive results. In preparation for this coming Monday, oh God, when they will be joining us, and they are going to make a pact with you. They are going, my Father, to make a pact with your word, because your word cannot return to you empty. It will certainly accomplish the purpose of which it was sent for. So I determine your blessings upon, my Father, all those who now pray with us. Bless their documents, their applications, bless their families, bless their relationship, bless their health. Enable them to see their dreams come true. Enable them to receive the answers that they have been expecting for the longest while. With victory, I determine them victorious. With prosperity, I determine them prosperous. With success, I determine them successful. With a blessing, I bless them all. Bless Trinidad and Tobago and all the other nations that now join us in prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in Jesus Christ's name. And those who agree say, Amen. My friend, you are blessed. God is with you. Doubt not, because God's words cannot return to him empty. And speaking about God's words returning to him empty, this Sunday, day after tomorrow, in all the universal churches of the kingdom of God, nationwide, Trinidad and Tobago, the word of God says, humble yourself under God's mighty hands. And he, in due time, will exalt you. Cast your cares, your anxieties upon him, for he cares about you. Maybe you are anxious about many things. Maybe you are worried about many things. I would like to invite you to be with us this Sunday at 7 a.m., 8:30 a.m., or 10 a.m. in any universal church of the kingdom of God nationwide, most especially in our national headquarters, number 40 South Quay, Port of Spain. Pastor Philip will be with you at 7 a.m. in our main service. I, Pastor Marcos, will be with you at 8:30 in the morning. And Pastor Junior will be with you at 10 o'clock in the morning. And we are going to humble ourselves before God. We are going to cast on him all our anxieties, our cares, that which has been causing us discontentment, disappointment, that which we have been waiting for the longest while and has been greatly disturbing us. The word of God says, humble yourselves under the mighty hands of God. And in due time, he will exalt you. Cast your cares, your anxieties on him, for he cares about you. So if we cast our cares, if we cast our anxieties upon the altar, if we place it in God's hands, he's going to take care of us. So if you are anxious about something, if you have been expecting certain things and it's causing you distress, it's even making you to feel depressed, get a piece of paper, write it down, and bring it with you to the closest universal church to you this Sunday at 7 a.m. or 8:30 a.m. or 10 a.m. Trinidad and Tobago. Because once we place your anxieties, your cares in Jesus' hands, he'll care about you. Let us watch this testimony of a person who have been filled with the Holy Spirit through the fasting of Daniel. And today, the life of this person is totally transformed. Be blessed in the name of Jesus.
My name is Andrea Campbell, and my life was a total disaster. I was a person who was very depressed, very sad, always living in self-pity. If I didn't have the love or the comfort of someone, then I would always be sad. Growing up, my family life was very bad. We were always fighting. There was always a fight in my house. Constantly there was fight. So to escape this situation, I got to drinking, smoking, and partying. There was never a day that I wasn't smoking. Each day I would smoke maybe 2 packs of cigarettes. 2 packs, and when the cigarette was not enough, then I turned to smoking ganja. It was so bad because even my brothers knew what I was doing, and as a teenager, they got involved in that because one of my brothers used to smoke marijuana regularly, always. And he would invite me to do it. He would invite me, he would buy it for me to do it. And at the time I thought that I was escaping the problem, but it wasn't really escaping the problem, it was making the situation worse. Because when I thought that I would be happy doing that, or I would find solution or solace, I found more pain. I found depression, sadness. I was so depressed that to the point that sometimes I would imagine falling off somewhere, breaking somewhere, just so that I could have the attention of people. It wasn't that my family didn't love me, but I grew up not knowing who my father was, and this was something that always used to bother me. So I used to go out a lot, I used to drink. I remember one night I drank so much that I passed out because I drank a whole bottle of gin without anything, a complete bottle of gin. And when I passed out by the gate, they called my sister, and I remember when I came to and I was in the house, she just looked at me and she said, "I don't know for whatever reason you are doing this, but the next time that you drink and you die, that will be it, because you chose to have this kind of life. You chose to be like this." But in going to parties, in drinking, in smoking, I was looking for some kind of happiness. I was looking for a way to get away from the problem. But that didn't help, because I realized that over some time, my mother, she started to be a different person, because my mother, she used to fight a lot. She used to quarrel, she used to curse very badly. My brothers, sisters, everybody in the house was always fighting. I'm telling you, it was so bad that there was not a day that I wanted to be home. Sunday to Sunday, I would be out. If I was not going to party, I would be with a group of friends walking the streets, just walking around, night after night. When I reach home, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, just to sleep and wake up. The next day is the same thing. But then I realized that my mother, she was quiet. She was different. So I was going to university at the time, and we didn't have condition. She didn't have condition. No one in my family had condition to pay for the university. And I remember it was coming very close to for me to do my exams. And they called me and they said, "Look, if you don't have the money, you can't do the exams." And I went home, I told my mother, and the only thing that I could do was cry, because for me, that was something that was important. It was important to me, because in all of everything, one of the things that I really wanted to do was to finish my education, because for me, that is what would help me to get out of the situation. And she said, "Look, we don't have the money. I don't know what we're going to do." I remember I spent 3 days crying. I just cried. And she, because she was coming to the church at the time, she gave me the bread and the water that she got in the church. And she said, "Eat it and drink it, because by faith we are going to get a solution." I didn't know what faith was. So for me, that was foolishness. Didn't make any sense. I remember I turned to her and I said, "But how is this going to give me the money that I need? It's not going to open the doors for us." She said, "Just obey and let's go." And we went out, and honestly, we got through. We got through, we got someone, and until today, I really don't know who it was who paid for my entire 3 years of school. And that's how I came to the church, because I was sick to the point that I could not move, because I used to suffer with very bad sinus, just bleeding constantly. And she said, "Look, I'm gonna take you to the church for the pastor to pray for you." When I came to the church, they prayed for me and immediately, no more pains. The pains disappear. And so I said to myself, okay, this looks like it would work. After some time, I decided to come on my own. I was coming on my own, but even though I was coming to church, for 2 full years I was coming to the church, but I never made any decision what I wanted to do with my life. I was in the church, but when I leave the church, I'll go to party. But I remember clearly one Friday night, it was a night vigil. And I'll never forget that night. It was like something different happened. And I remember after the whole night, and again, I had the same thing I manifested. And when I opened my eyes, I was different. I felt different. I felt light. And I decided that, look, I'm gonna start to be serious. But even though we say that sometimes it's hard to really let go of the life, the friends, and the situations of outside. So for me, it was really a fight. It was a fight. It was a hard decision that I had to make, but I made it. I went to church on Sunday. I decided that I was going to start to fight and I was going to let go of the old life. And that's what I did. I started to come Sundays. I started to come Fridays to seek for my deliverance. And I started to come Wednesdays. And it had an assistant who was always there, used to help me to pray. And they said, look, if you want to have a different life, if you really want to change, you have to decide to put God first. You have to let go of everything that is holding you, not only just the physical things, but you have to let go of the pain, the hurt, the feelings that are inside that is bad. The grudges that you have to let go of the anger that you have towards your father and your relatives, because God cannot come to a person who is constantly with the old life, with the old thoughts, with the old feelings. And so I decided to, I would start to seek. So they taught me, they show me what's the way to do. So I decided now I'm going to start to fast. They teach me how to fast, how to pray, how to seek for God. And that's what I did. I used to wake up 12 o'clock, I used to wake up 3 o'clock, I used to fast, I used to pray, I used to seek. And in doing so, little by little, I started to let go of the hard feeling, that the feelings that I had towards them was not the same. I realized that I didn't really need to have that hate, that anger, because I came to a place that people who were not my family, were not my relatives, they accepted me. And I realized that I didn't have to fight for the love of anyone outside. So I started to seek, and I remember the day that I received the Holy Spirit. I had this assurance, this certainty that no matter what I face in life, no matter the difficulties, I would be able to overcome. I had joy, I had peace. I had the assurance that someone loves me, that someone is with me, no matter the troubles, the fights, the difficulties. Because when I received the Holy Spirit, my life didn't just magically change. But this time, I didn't have to run away from the problems. I didn't have to run away from the situations that I faced. I was able to stand up and fight. I was able to overcome the things that came to me. I know that with God, I'm worth something. And I know that with Him, no matter what happens, I will overcome. That He was the one that was able to help me to achieve everything that I want. Because without Him, I cannot do anything.